Good morning and welcome to St. Agnes. Today we celebrate the 14th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our readings can be found in the back of the hymnal, number 1148. Our entrance hymn is number 569, Jesus Shall Reign, number 569.
Let us continue our celebration by calling upon God as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. May the grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pause for a moment and consider how we stand before God and one another. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you.
Let us pray. O God, who in the abasement of your Son have raised up a fallen world, fill your faithful with holy joy, for on those you have rescued from the slavery of sin, you bestow eternal gladness. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zechariah. Thus says the Lord, "Rejoice heartily, O daughter Zion. Shout for joy, O daughter Jerusalem. See, your king shall come to you. A just savior is he, meek and riding on an ass, on a colt, the foal of an ass. He shall banish the chariot from Ephraim and the horse from Jerusalem. The warrior's bow shall be banished, and he shall proclaim peace to the nations. His dominion shall be from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Compassionate to all his creatures. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God. All your works shall thank you, O Lord, and all your faithful ones bless you. They shall speak of the glory of your reign and declare your mighty deeds. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God. Is faithful in all his words and holy in all his deeds. The Lord supports all who fall and raises up all who are bowed down. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, you are not in the flesh. On the contrary, you are in the Spirit, if only the Spirit of God dwells in you. Whoever does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. If the Spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, the one who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies also, through his Spirit that dwells in you. Consequently, brothers and sisters, we are not debtors to the flesh to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. To little ones, the mysteries of the kingdom. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. At that time, Jesus exclaimed, "I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the little ones. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart. You will find rest for yourselves, for my yoke is easy and my burden light." The Gospel of the Lord. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Not only was this passage from St. Matthew one of St. Francis de Sales' favorite passages in Scripture, it is the passage upon which he built his entire spirituality. Gentleness, humility, compassion. Among many of the titles that have been given to Francis de Sales, one of the most popular and I think one of the most appropriate is the Gentleman Saint. Francis writes in his introduction to the Devout Life, and I quote, "Take care that gentleness and humility are found within your heart. Little by little, bring your quick mind around to being patient, gentle, humble, and affable in the midst of the pettiness, the childishness, and the imperfections of others. Humility and gentleness are true and good when they preserve us from the inflammation and swelling that injuries usually cause in our hearts," end quote. And Francis does not include or exclude ourselves from the need of gentleness and compassion. He believed that one of the best exercises in gentleness and compassion we can perform is in ourselves. Listen to his words of compassion when we sin. Reason requires that we must be displeased and sorrowful whenever we commit a fault. Yet when we do so, we must refrain from bitter, gloomy, spiteful, and emotional displeasures in ourselves. We correct ourselves much better by calm, steady repentance rather than harshness. Even when we have committed serious sin, Francis wants us to recognize it, to confess it, to develop a strategy to refrain from committing that sin. But he wants us to do that in a gentle, reasonable, and compassionate way. He writes, "Alas, my poor heart, here we are, fallen into the pit we so firmly resolved to avoid. Well, we must get up again and leave it forever. Let us start out again on the way by trusting God, because God will help us, and with his grace and our cooperation with his grace, we will do better." Francis was far ahead of his time in his knowledge and application of solid, sound, and healthy psychology. His psychology was based, of course, on an understanding of Christian humanism. He realized that inward peace develops when we have confessed, made amends, and incorporated a reasonable and healthy strategy to change. And so he recognized that when you are inwardly peaceful, what is sometimes today referred to as mindfulness, when you have that inward peacefulness, you are able to perform many acts of gentleness, and by doing so, develop a spirit of compassion, both with others and oneself. Listen to his words. "As long as reason rules and peaceably chastises, corrects, and warns, even though firmly and exactly, everyone can accept it." He ends that section of the introduction to the Devout Life writing this: "If we find ourselves aroused to anger, we must call for God's help like the apostles when the wind and the storm toss them about. We must remember this life is only a journey to a happy life to come. We must march as companions, united in gentleness, in peace, and in love." Francis wants us to realize that we are never alone in our struggles to live a consistent life, consistent with the teachings of the Church, consistent with Holy Scripture. We not only have each other here on earth to support us, but Francis reminds us that we are part of a larger community, the community of saints and angels. But it's not magic. We must do our part consciously and willfully, accepting the grace that God sends us, and by using them to wisely, reasonably, and in a healthy way, develop concrete strategies to correct our sinfulness. With serious, repetitive, and habitual behaviors, perhaps God's grace is telling us, directing us to spiritual direction, to pastoral counseling, in order to assist us in developing these strategies. Today's gospel emphasizes that we are never alone. We don't have to face life's challenges and struggles feeling abandoned or unaided. We are part of an active, grace-filled community, our church, both our local church and church universal. Think of being in that boat with the apostles when the wind and storms tossed them about. They depended on each other, and they depended on the grace and the presence of Christ. Let us do the same. And may God continue to bless you as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Having heard God's word and having reflected upon what that word means in our lives, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pause now as we place our petitions before the throne of God.
For all of our church leaders, especially Pope Francis, Bishop Burbage, and our parish priests, that they will preach the gospel with courage and conviction, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our nation, that together we will promote the common good of all, safeguard the sanctity of marriage and the family, and defend the rights to life and to religious freedom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For justice, security, and peace among nations, and for those who serve in our law enforcement, military, intelligence, and diplomatic services to make peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the end of the war in Ukraine, the withdrawal of Russia, and the restoration of justice and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Christians who face persecution and genocide, especially in communist and Islamic countries, that the Holy Spirit will keep them strong in the faith, and for all non-believers, that the Holy Spirit will move them to faith in our divine Savior, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the acceptance of vocations to the priesthood and religious life, that young men and women from our own families will heed Christ's call and offer their lives to him who gave his life for us, and for our parish seminarians, Deacon James Joseph, Gabriel Godet, Michael Gibbons, and John Anthony Buono, and for Sister Monica Baptiste Whalen and Sister Abigail Therese Jones, novices for the Dominican Sisters in Nashville, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and homebound, and for our deceased, especially Lucille Meal Carrick, John Hui Nguyen Long, and Catherine Dutcher, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Father Tony Bennett, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for our own personal intentions held in the quiet of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty Father, we come before you this morning with our prayers and petitions. We ask you to hear the petitions which we have spoken aloud and all the prayers and petitions each of us holds in our hearts. We place them before you in the name of Christ Jesus, your Son. Amen.
Our offertory hymn is number 707. I heard the voice of Jesus say, number 707. Thank you.
so weary, worn, and sad. I found in him a resting place, and he has made me glad. I heard the voice of Jesus say, "Behold, I freely give." The living water, thirsty one, stoop down and drink and live. I came to Jesus and I drink of that life-giving stream. My thirst was quenched, my soul revived, and now I live in him.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice for the praise and glory of his name, for our good of all his holy church.
May this oblation dedicated to your name purify us, O Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the life of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy.
Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once again, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Thank you. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
And see the grace eternal, taste and see.
that God is good. All who hunger, never strangers, seeker, be a welcome guest. Come from restlessness and roaming, here in joy we keep the feast. We that once were lost and scattered in communion's love have stood. Taste and see the grace eternal. Taste and see that God is good. All who hunger, sing together. Jesus Christ is living bread. Come from loneliness and longing, here in peace we have been led. Blessed are those who from this table live their days in gratitude. Taste and see the grace eternal. Taste and see that God is good.
Go out to our brothers and sisters who are unable to be here with us today. Read to them from Holy Scripture, offer them the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, and give them our love and regards. And may you go in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. There's only one announcement this morning. Our poor box collection this weekend is for Red Cloud Sioux Indian School, staffed by the Jesuits on the Pine Ridge Reservation in South Dakota. Let us pray. Grant we pray, O Lord, that having been replenished by such great gifts, we may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God. Our recessional hymn is number 610, Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven, number 610.
Praise the everlasting King. Praise the